Brandis, for the first time, scientists have successfully been able to grow monkey embryos containing human cells. Researchers at the Salk Institute for Biological Studies in California, working in collaboration with Chinese scientists, grew the embryos in a dish with some surviving up to 20 days. They published their research last week, immediately igniting debate over the ethics of such research and sparking fears of human-monkey hybrids. Joining us now to help us understand the reality behind the unsettling headlines is INSOO, professor of bioethics and philosophy at Case Western Reserve University in Ohio and the director of research ethics at Harvard Medical School. HYUN is also involved in developing guidelines to govern this type of research. Professor, thank you so much for joining us. And before we get into the issue of whether or not this is a good or a bad thing, explain just like mechanically what it is these scientists did.
That's right, thank you. So they took sperm and eggs from monkeys, mixed them in a dish to make monkey embryos. And these embryos, as you must know, have never been in a monkey's body. They were created in a lab in a dish. Once those monkey embryos got to just a few days old, at the pre-implantation stage, they transferred about 25 human stem cells, injected them into these embryos, and watched how these stem cells interacted with the monkey cells for about up to 20 days.
And we're looking at an image of that embryo, and the red dots are the human genetic material that is in the embryo. But please continue.
Right, I'm glad you're showing this image because many people, when they first heard of this experiment, had images of Planet of the Apes in their minds, right? They had images of human-monkey hybrids that are somehow visually a mixture of the two species. But really what you see here is the extent to which these embryos were grown. They look like mini disco balls. They look nothing like an animal. And so this is because they used the embryos at a pre-implantation stage before they got complex and formed structures like limbs or organs. Now, why did they do this? Many people are curious about why science would do such a radical thing. To answer that question, we have to get to really what is the ultimate purpose of this kind of experiment?
What is the ultimate purpose?
The ultimate purpose is to learn how to better get to the point where we can grow transplantable human organs in livestock animals like sheep or pigs. There is a drastic shortage of organs for transplantation in the United States and worldwide. In fact, in the United States, about 18 people every day die while waiting for an organ on the organ wait list. So there has to be radical strategies to ease that shortage and to help save American lives. The strategy of growing human organs in a livestock animal, which is evolutionarily very distant from human, right? Pigs and sheep are very, very unlike human beings. That strategy has not worked because injecting human stem cells into a pig or sheep embryo that's been genetically modified to lack an organ, which then the human stem cells will provide. Those human stem cells have not survived for very long in that foreign host environment. So researchers have to have a better understanding of how to overcome what's called the xenobarrier, the barrier between human species and non-human species. And to better learn that, we have to work with a species that's much closer to human beings, which would be the monkey.
Professor, the monkey
embryos to learn about how human cells can interact with non-human cells at a very early stage before implantation.
Professor, as we mentioned, these embryos with these monkey embryos with the injected human material only lasted about 20 days. If it lasts, is it the goal for it to last longer? And at that point, might not society get into more troubling aspects than just trying to figure out how cells talk to each other to promote transplantation?
Right. That's an excellent question. The reason why they tracked the embryos for 20 days was that's the maximum limit of how long technologically you can keep monkey embryos alive in a dish that have never been in a monkey body. So what you would have to do to go any further beyond that point is to implant the embryo into a uterus of a monkey. Now, nobody wants to do that at this point.
Might that happen, though? It seems as if this might be a preparatory step for the implantation of that embryo into a macaque monkey, which is the material that the macaque monkey is the one that's been providing this material.
That's right. That's right. Well, certainly you're correct that if the goal is to grow human organs in sheep and pigs, then those sheep and pig embryos with human cells would be transplanted into a uterus and brought to full term. That's correct, because you have to have a living adult animal to provide the organ for transplant. But for the monkey work, nobody wants to grow human organs in a little monkey. In fact, that human organ would be way too small to be of any good. So there's no point in gestating the monkey embryo. You just want to study cell-to-cell communication, and you can answer that research question without implantation. So I would draw the line right now at implantation. You can study the embryo in the dish in that disco ball format, but implantation and pregnancy of a monkey embryo that has human cells, that's a lot more troubling. And nobody wants to do that. That's not scientifically justified for the purpose of growing organs in sheep and pigs.
But if something can be done, is there a possibility that some scientist might go rogue and do something that could result in a creature that has some component of human consciousness?
That's right. That is obviously a concern for everybody. And there are no guarantees, right? Even if we have strict rules and laws, people can always break them. People have been known to break rules in science. But the public needs to know that there is a pretty rigorous structure in place, both for animal research full stop, and also for research involving human stem cells at the international level. So even if the Salk team worked with researchers in China, which have expertise in making monkey embryos and culturing them for 20 days, both research teams had to get institutional approval at their Chinese and California institutions, but also had to follow international laws and rules for animal research on the one hand, and the international guidelines for stem cell research. So there really is all efforts made to have clear guidance on this kind of work, understanding that there's quite a bit of controversy in this type of research. But anytime you have any type of law, you know, laws do not actually 100% prevent that behavior. Regarding the scientists that might go rogue and do this, I wouldn't even call them scientists, because there's no scientific reason to gestate a human chimera in a monkey model without a clear plan as to what the benefit to society is for doing that.
Professor HYUN, thank you so much for your insights. Fascinating story. We appreciate it.
Thank you.